This morning, we have a special privilege here to have one of our own young upstarts to speak today. Eric spoke once before, and he had a little difficulty filling up the whole time, and we're pretty early today yet, so he's got lots of time. But Jim's going to fill in whenever Eric runs out of steam. So now, he went yesterday to watch the conference of the young people, went to participate, actually, I'm sure. And it was a good conference, and Gregory said they enjoyed it, and he said he'd probably share a bit of that as well, too. So, Eric, God bless you as you come forward and speak to our hearts and minds through Jesus Christ and through the Holy Spirit.
Good morning.
Good morning.
My plan this time is just to talk really slow. That's how I'm going to fix that. Okay, so my message for this morning, I feel like I'm really loud. My message for this morning is called Called to Be Ambassadors for Christ. So we'll be talking about our mission, the Great Commission, which is to spread the good word of God to as many people as we can. That's our goal. So I guess I must not have scared Pastor Jim enough last time, because he's asked me to come up here again. So we'll see what we can do today. So yesterday was Change Conference, and do we have any like early morning people here? We're the morning people. Can you just raise your hands? Morning people? Morning people? Good. Okay, everyone else, pay attention. These are the people we're going to avoid. We're going to stay away from the morning people. So if you know me, I'm not a morning person. I like my Saturday mornings. I like to sleep in as long as I can, which isn't often very long. But yesterday was Change Conference, so we had to be in Delhi and pick up the youth and be in Toronto for 8:30. So God bless Larissa, who had the task of getting me out of bed at 6:30. We'll actually be having a prayer session at the back for anyone who's ever to wake me up. Now, the Change Conference was incredible. It was a full day celebrating and enjoying being in the presence of God with thousands of other believers and hundreds, and it was just a room full of thousands of youth that were all giving everything to God through praise, through worship, just being in His presence. The worship team there is phenomenal. It was unreal to listen to that. We took some notes for our own worship team, and the guest speakers had incredibly powerful messages. They really were able to touch, I know myself, I know they were really geared to youth, but even myself, it was really touching to hear what they had to say. So there's actually a video that they have just kind of like recapping, so I wanted to throw that on the screen and show you guys what we were doing yesterday. Supposed to be sound, but I'm not going to sing for you guys, so just imagine this sound. So I'll just kind of describe what's going on here. So the day was filled with concerts, with guest speakers, so you can see here just kids, youth celebrating, just jam-packed front of the rows, jumping, celebrating, singing, praising, and giving their lives to God. It does flow nicer when you play the whole video.
Life ain't been the same since death died. Wanted by a landslide. Hallelujah to the flex, my. That power made a point, next slide. Ripping this side. Shoes ain't Gucci, I just keep my foot on reptiles. Coming for my neck now. When the game about to end, you expect fouls. Oh, vanity, Satan try to cancel me. I don't feel your plan for me. I just made a canopy. When you come to handle me, there's another hand on me.
Yeah, so it was incredible. It was a lot of fun. But last night, myself and the other leaders got to witness something absolutely incredible. We watched hundreds, if not thousands, of youth packed in the front rows, cheering, praying, and worshiping in the presence of God. We watched as many of them took the next step, committing their lives to Christ right before our eyes. It was amazing. At one point, the youth were actually running to the front rows to fill it as much as they could, like physically running towards God. And I pray that everyone in this room gets to experience that at least once, because it was amazing to see. So as Christians, it's our ultimate mission to spread the word of God to others and use our testimony to inspire others to explore God for themselves. It's not just about us and our personal faith. It's about sharing the love that we've found with the rest of the world. So I'm going to kick it off with a verse from 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 20, which tells us, "We are Christ's ambassadors, as though God were making his appeal through us." So the starting point is understanding our own identity as Christians. So we'll start with the basics. We're not just believers. We're a chosen bunch. We're kind of like a royal... I don't like the way that this was written, but I'm going to read it the way that I wrote it because I'm not good off ad lib. We're not just believers. We're a bit like a royal priesthood, part of a holy nation, and God's special crew. So we're, in my own words, like God's special ops team. But it really just means that we're his representatives right here on earth.
Amen.
And Jesus gave a commission, gave us a mission, and not just any mission, I gave it away, the Great Commission. He said, "Go and make disciples of all nations." Jesus didn't say, "If you feel like it." He said, "Go and make disciples of all nations." That's the Great Commission. This is our call to spread the love, make more disciples, and be living proof that God's grace is real. It's kind of like the ultimate friend referral program. So Matthew chapter 28, verses 19 to 20, I'm just going to read these for you. "Therefore, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey with everything I have commanded you. And surely I'm with you always to the very end of age." So this is Jesus telling you and I that we're on a quest. But instead of a treasure hunt, it's a people hunt. We're searching for hearts that need God's love. So just to make this clear, Jesus is calling you and I to help build the kingdom of God. Is that not pretty cool? We're involved in that plan. It blows me away. But you know what's incredible? It's the way that God transforms lives. People in the darkest of places find light through faith. Kind of like watching a caterpillar turn into a butterfly. Which I'm afraid of, if you didn't know that. It's like a weird phobia that I've had since I was a kid. I can't explain it. That's just the way it is. Stories of recovery, redemption, and love conquering hate are very powerful. They're our testimony. It's how we spread what God's done in our lives to others. So last night we heard the testimony of Pastor Micah, which I'm largely just going to read from here. He had grown up in a broken family and became the man of his house in his teenage years and helped his mother make ends meet and raise his younger sisters. He taught us about how being a believer doesn't mean a life free of trouble. This was a big point in his message. Being a believer does not mean a life free of trouble. In fact, Jesus actually tells us we will face trouble in this world. He guarantees that. But as believers, we can rejoice in the fact that Jesus offers us peace when we're surrounded by troubles that would cause a non-believer to worry and fear. Our peace isn't a mental state, but it's a person, and that person is Jesus.
Amen.
So when Pastor Micah's sister was 8 years old, his mother took her to the hospital with a concerning lump on her leg. This lump turned out to be a tumor. And she was diagnosed with stage 4 cancer and given a 20% chance of survival. After 2 years of battling cancer, now age 10, it had spread to her lungs, which meant for their family that their conversation shifted from curing her cancer to how much time. It was at this point in her fight with cancer that a pastor at her church told her, "You will one day use your story to witness to others the glory of God." Now that's a big thing to tell a 10-year-old who was just diagnosed and is talking about how much time they have left. At her next appointment, the doctors reported her cancer was no longer in her lungs, and Pastor Micah told us that she'd been completely cured of her cancer.
Amen.
But the story doesn't end there. The doctors also told her that she'd never be able to carry a child because of the chemicals used during treatment. And Pastor Micah became visibly emotional when he was telling us about holding his miracle nephew for the first time. So his sister now does full-time ministry and uses her story to spread the word of God to others. So why did I tell you this today? Because these testimonies are proof that God's still in the transformation business, and this proof is what we can use to inspire others to join our walk with God. Every day, the Lord performs miracles like this that change not just the life of the individual who receives it, but potentially the life of any other individual that hears this story. That's the power of your testimony. So what do? We're called to live as examples. How do we live as ambassadors for Christ? It's about being real life examples of God's love. So your speech, your actions, your love, and your faith, they should all reflect God's love. It's like being a superhero in your own story, and your superpower is love. Wherever you are, in your job, in your school, in your neighborhood, or even in your home, you are God's representative. You're his own superhero, changing the world one act of love at a time. So how can we do this? I've made a list of a few practical ways that you can live as ambassadors for Christ in your own life. So understanding your identity as a Christian, as an ambassador for Christ, deepening your own faith, serving others, loving unconditionally, praying for guidance, building relationships, this is a big one, building relationships and just getting to know people, you can really, as you get to know somebody in a deeper relationship, they open up and you open up to each other. And you'll be able to see places in their life that God can work. So that's a big one, building relationships. Forgiving freely, staying humble, we're ambassadors, we're not saviors, and praying for others. Praying generally, spending time with God. You're not going to like me. This slide says conclusion. So, to wrap it up early again, remember that as Christians, we're ambassadors of Christ. We've dived into our identity, the Great Commission, the miraculous power of God's grace, and the mission to lead by example. So now, I'm calling all of you, and myself as well, it's time that we roll up our sleeves and get to work. We've got to share the love that we've found with the rest of the world. This is a mission filled with purpose, with joy, and the knowledge that we're making a real difference in the world.
Amen.
Let's take a moment to pray. Dear God, we're truly grateful for the role that you've given us. Help us find the strength, the wisdom, and the love we need to fulfill the mission. May we be that shining light, guiding others to you in your abundant love. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.